Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Yusuf Ali Tyagi, and we are going to discuss a question which is very relevant and a prototype in relation to the pattern of the fracture. The kind of the question was first asked in the JIPMER examination 2014, and how the questions are framed, how the things are provided to you in the question, how to sum them up in order to reach the final diagnosis. This is what we are going to learn out of this question based upon the pattern of the fractures. If you read the question, that 7-year-old boy sustained injury to his right leg after falling from chair while playing. So one, the mechanism of injury is provided to you. Following which, he was not able to bear weight on the affected limb. That means a significant trauma resulting in fracture. And there was no limb deformity. That is the third hint which is provided to you. Summing all these things up, you have to reach the final answer, that what is the pattern of the fracture. In order to understand this answer for this particular ask or the question, you need to understand what is a spiral kind of the fractures. All of us have seen a spiral staircase that runs along the long axis in the center. Similarly, if a bone is broken spirally along the long axis or the longitudinal axis, it is known as a spiral fracture. The mechanism of injury for causing these spiral fracture is a rotational or a torsional injuries. Rotational twisting or the torsional injuries. It is not very difficult to understand that if a bone is subjected to a twisting force or a rotational force or a twisting or torsional force, then it will result in the spiral kind of the breakdown. But what is more important as one of the characteristic finding of the spiral fracture that you try to understand from the imagination is that imagine this to be a bone which has a spiral kind of the breakdown starting at this level. This spiral fracture is having a break at the anterior cortex, but the posterior cortex will be intact. So it is the intact posterior cortex which is preventing the displacement at this level. When you move a level higher, it is the medial cortex which is broken, but the lateral cortex is intact at this level. So there will be no displacement. And you move a level higher, at this level, it is the posterior cortex which is broken, but the anterior cortex is intact, as a result of which there is no displacement. So overall in a spiral fracture, there is minimal or no displacement at the site of the fractures. No displacement. And this is the reason why the limb is not going to have the obvious deformity, because of no or minimal displacement. So because there is no or minimal displacement at the site of fracture, there will be no or minimal deformity in the limb. So spiral fractures are characterized by minimal or no deformity in the limb. And if you go back to the question, the first hint which was provided to you was a fall from chair while playing. Imagine a child who was playing on the chair, suddenly falls down, so he might have sustained a rotational or a twisting injury to his leg. Second point, following which he was not able to bear weight, that means there is a fracture. It is a significant injury that resulted in the fracture. And the third point is that there was no deformity of the limb. All of these previously kept hint are now finalized, culminated into your final diagnosis, and the final diagnosis for that question is a spiral fracture. Hope you have understood the basic pattern mechanism related questions that are usually kept in the PG entrance related examinations.